Hey everyone, it's Justin again. Now that we've learned about constructions relating to lines and line segments, let's start getting into some calculations. One of the calculations you'll be learning is the distance formula, and refreshing our memory on the Pythagorean theorem will help to make the distance formula easier to understand. So let's do it. Let's review the Pythagorean theorem. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to find the third side of a right triangle given two of its sides. First, we'll review the Pythagorean theorem, and then we'll complete two examples. Do you remember what a right triangle is? A right triangle is a triangle with a right angle, which is marked right here. On a right triangle, the sides have certain names. The hypotenuse is the longest side of the triangle, and it's always opposite to the right angle. The two sides that meet up at the right angle are called the legs. The Pythagorean theorem says, in a right triangle, the sum of the squares of the length of the legs is equal to the square of the length of the hypotenuse. That may seem a little confusing, but let me explain what that means. We label the legs with A and B, and the hypotenuse with C. It's very important to make sure that C always represents the hypotenuse, but A and B could switch places and it wouldn't really matter. Using these labels, we can then write the formula for the Pythagorean theorem. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. For example, here's a super common right triangle, the 3-4-5 triangle. It's true that 3 squared plus 4 squared equals 5 squared, since 9 plus 16 equals 25. The sides of most triangles don't come out this nicely, but if they do, we call those numbers a Pythagorean triple. Some other examples would be 6, 8, 10, or 8, 15, 17. And we'll see another one on the next slide. Oh, and one more thing. Did you notice that we wrote 3 squared plus 4 squared, even though 3 is actually B and 4 is actually A? Well, we could have just as easily written 4 squared plus 3 squared and gotten the same answer, since addition is commutative. So, while you have to always label the hypotenuse C when you're doing the Pythagorean formula, it doesn't matter which leg you label as A and which leg you label as B. Now that you remember what the Pythagorean theorem is, pause the video and try to solve this for its unknown side. Remember that the hypotenuse had to be plugged in as C. C is the side opposite of the right angle, which here is also labeled X. Now we can label our legs in either order, so we'll just let A equal 5 and B equal 12. Then we use the Pythagorean theorem formula. If you have any of this wrong so far, pause the video now and fix your mistakes. Then, go ahead and solve for X, or C, if you haven't already. Okay, we'll substitute our values in for A, B, and C, and then we'll calculate the values of these squares. Next, we can add 25 and 144 to make 169. Then, for the final step, we have to get X by itself, which means we have to get rid of the squared next to the X. To do this, we'll take the square root of both sides, since squared and square root cancel each other out, and this will give us X equals 13. And that's it. That's the length of the hypotenuse of this triangle. Here's another example. Find the length of the missing side of the following triangle. See if you notice anything different about this problem compared to the one we just finished. This time, we are given the hypotenuse. So pause the video here and try to solve this. First, we label the sides. Remember, the hypotenuse has to be our C value, so we get that C is 18. However, if you switched your A and B from what I have here, that's totally okay. Then, we plug these into the formula, substituting our values in for B and C. Then, we square both of the numbers. This time, we'll subtract 9 from both sides, since we're trying to get this variable by itself. The only problem now is that the variable is still being squared, so just like in the previous problem, we have to take the square root of both sides. This is a good answer, and much more accurate than typing it into a calculator and rounding, but we can simplify it further. We can break 315 down into 9 times 35, so we can factor a 9 out, taking its square root. This will give us that A, our missing side length, is 3 times the square root of 35. And now you can use the Pythagorean theorem to solve for the third side of a right triangle. The Pythagorean theorem is so important in this course, and to what you're going to learn next. So if you aren't confident in everything we just did in this video, take advantage of the review options described in your notes template. Don't put it off. Definitely take advantage of them now, because I want you to be confident in what you get to learn later on. Anyways, I'll see you next time. Hey.